Hope this is the right track. It is. Okay, here we go.
Summer drinking, endless rosé.
How are these fuckers not all in AA?
Pretty people with booming careers.
Lover boy, enough to last 7 years.
Hampton's clubs don't activate hubs. India, oh, the summer house. Oh, well, oh, well,
sing
oh, well.
It with us.
Tell me more, tell me more.
Will they take Hannah's calls? Can we see Carl's three balls?
Shoo bop bop, 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 yeah.
Well, now we know why this is a two-part reunion.
I guess so.
Holy shit.
This was bonkers.
A lot of tea spilt.
A lot of tea spilt and a lot of crazy shown.
Wow.
This.
Just to clarify, if you guys want to know the repercussions of this reunion.
No, this is Summer House,
this
by the way.
This is Summer House.
Reunion should be fun.
This was not fun. It was juicy.
It's juicy. Reunion part one, everybody.
Big news. This has just been, I don't know when
big
this was
news.
Filmed.
Poodle got a new sex play. Oh, wait. Other big news.
Play blanket.
Play blanket. Literally, y'all, you got to answer.
It's waterproof,
like,
y'all.
You got a waterproof play blanket.
I.
You should sell those in the merch store.
The kind, this is the kind that, like, for old dogs, you put on your bed so your dogs, the old dogs, don't pee on your bed.
We should make a pillow for our sissy squad that says, this is my sex pillow.
This is my sex pillow.
And then people can buy it for their sex pillows.
Yeah. This is my sex pillow.
Don't think they'll be waterproof because our merchandise is cheap, but it all goes to charity.
It's true. But the big news that came out of this tell, this was filmed. This is really important to know. Obviously, they can't talk about it. It was filmed after Winter House was filmed. The most recent season. I don't know. But it was filmed after.
Sorry, the reunion or?
The reunion was filmed after they filmed Winter House season two. So, in other words, they had filmed that already.
Okay. So, I'm going to jump in.
But no, I was going to say. As of this morning, y'all, Paige DeSorbo has deleted her Twitter.
Oh, yeah, she deleted her Twitter.
So that's the big... If you wondered what fallout this would be, Ciara's actually been said that she's thinking about doing the same. So they've gotten some heat, obviously,
yeah,
from this, both of them. Mostly because they were the ones who engaged the most in this.
Well, it makes sense that...
Amanda's not deleting her Twitter.
I don't blame him. I want to delete mine half the time. People are terrible on Twitter.
They are.
It makes sense that know that it's after, now that you clarified, season two of Winter House. So meeting y'all, we haven't seen season two of Winter House yet.
Right.
It looks juicy from the trailer. I wasn't excited about it, but the trailer looks juicy. However, watching this the whole time, I thought my main teabag was, what did I miss? Mm-hmm. Because it just feels like we missed something that happened behind the scenes, behind a curtain that we're not aware of. And now it's all starting to paint a picture between this, between Craig talking shit about on he and Austen's live podcast about Carl and Lindsay's relationship.
Yep.
It just makes sense that either shit went off behind the cameras or shit goes down in Winter House.
I think there's a mixture of the two of that.
And that we're just not privy to yet because I...
Well, remember that Lindsay and Carl are not full cast members on Winter House. They are making an appearance there. But Craig and Paige
full
are.
On. So here's the deal, what doesn't add up for me. I'm going to say this. Like, say what you want. It wasn't the best behavior. That said, I love Paige. And I feel like Paige...
I don't really after last night, honestly.
I do. I love Paige. And I'm not going to throw away the 5 years or the years I've had of getting to know Paige and seeing her. But I want to say this does not look like the Paige that I know.
Oh, I see what you're saying.
That's why I was a little like, huh. And so I'm going to full on reserve my judgment until we see Winter House. But I'm confused. I feel like it's a new person I haven't seen before. I hope, though, because I feel like usually, and I've said this before on Summer House, usually what Paige says on prior seasons usually is the most, often can be the most reasonable and kind of dead-on opinion.
Yeah.
And so I'm, this was not that at always. Sometimes it was, but I don't, that's where I'm like, I'm not going to, personally for me, I'm not canceling her yet because I still believe in Paige. I'm not regretting it.
I'm not here to cancel her.
I know you're not either, but I know people are.
Yeah, I think what for me this I realized is she now believes what everyone says about her. There was a kind of a realism for her that was always trying to go towards Mean Girl.
Can you give a specific of that?
Yes. Just to in other words, that she's. I think she was always trying to be the reality show sweetheart with the perfect boyfriend.
Mm-hmm.
And I really do think she resents Lindsay and Carl completely.
Mm-hmm.
By the way she looked at them. I think she's upset about the coverage they get.
She was super hot.
Yeah.
So there's something that is beyond what, yeah. Yeah.
I think it's that she now, I think she could always, be clear. She could always remove herself and she could always cast a kind of a sarcastic eye on reality television. And that's why we liked her.
Yeah, you always felt like Paige leaned, something would happen dramatic and she would look at the camera and wink.
Yeah.
She wouldn't do that physically, but you would get that feeling.
I don't think she's doing that anymore.
It seemed more real life to her.
That's when it totally went into, I need to protect what's mine. And
maybe she never cared about it because she never was in love with someone
right.
in a relationship. But now she actually cares about that, maybe?
But what is she defending?
Maybe there's what some part ask. That's defending her. I don't know. But it seems like she's defending something, whether it's like her and Craig or... Because she said things that pulled back the curtain on the show that we have actually said that I was kind of surprised as a cast member she just full out said.
Like, what was that?
The whole thing we've talked about from the beginning of... If you're not an OG person from season one, you're not included yeah. in this show.
And that is true to an extent, but that's also, she's trying to rewrite a narrative. Because what happened was, for her to say that it was hard, that she felt like she was the one who had to go to the new people, that's garbage. Because of the way they all, especially Amanda and Paige, treated Jules in season three, we will never. That was mean girl behavior.
Yeah.
And this, the reason why it's hard to get into that group is it's a question of age, especially for women.
Yeah.
Women, Danielle and Lindsay, are going to resent women who are younger than they are. Of course, women who are younger than they are do not want to hang out with older women.
Yeah, I think for me, overall thoughts with this...
I just found their argument crap, honestly.
Yeah, I mean, I haven't seen it, but I've heard that what the way Jules are treated. Not that people love Jules, but she's treated.
No, she's terrible.
I think... The deal is, it's a lot of things Paige and Ciara were saying, I didn't disagree with. I totally... And Amanda, some... I totally agreed, with what they're saying, and... But it's definitely the difference of two. You can tell who literally owns a PR company and knows how to spin their narrative versus the people that didn't.
It's sitting like, there like a queen, Lindsay.
You know, first rule of PR is you don't go into a public situation full of emotion.
No.
And Ciara and Paige were just all emotion.
Yep.
And so... And you, whether it they're coming from a factual, sensible point of view, but if it's shrouded in this just fiery spew of an emotional narrative, it's going to make someone look crazy,
especially on camera.
Not crazy. I don't want to say that because it's women, but ridiculous compared to someone like Lindsay, who not only does her face not move, y'all, but also her emotions don't move on camera. She's very cunning.
She looked good too.
I thought they all looked good, actually.
I loved Paige's. I don't like Paige's wet look.
Oh, I loved it. I loved her curly hair. Loved it.
No, but
Ciara
like
beautiful in the
Ciara
gold.
Ciara looked great, but Amanda's look.
I don't remember Amanda's look, so it's forgettable.
But it's the
Danielle
same.
Danielle looked horrible.
Oh, Danielle's makeup. What
did she do with her makeup?
Oh, it looked terrible.
It was this weird bronzer, and it just looked, it didn't match her neck. It looked bad.
It was full on Chola makeup.
It was bad. It was not good. It was not good.
But no, I was talking about, like, Amanda had, Lindsay, to an extent, they had bronzer on. Amanda had way too much bronzer on.
Yeah, she'll put too much bronzer
on. But it's that.
Maya looked pretty.
That wet. She did. The wet look was too much for me for Paige with the hair.
Luke looked really good. His makeup
looked good. I thought he was heavily made up. I thought he was trying the least. Carl, and I can't believe they let Carl and Alex wear the same suit. Or yeah, a color. Even if it wasn't the same suit.
By the way,
come on, y'all.
Alex was there. Just don't forget, Alex was there. Also, Andre brought Lexi. I don't care. I'm sorry.
Okay.
If you have a tea bag of Lexi and Andre, I'm going to say no. You can't
I
say
said
it.
She br- I said he brought
it.
Her, and I was like, was she contractually obligated to appear because we talked about her whole season?
If you tuned into this recap
to
tune into that, you're basic. We're not talking about it. Anyway, what's your first?
The funniest thing is, I think it's funny how they'll accept Andrea and Lexi's relationship, but they won't accept Carl and Lindsay's. What does that say?
I still believe Carl and Lindsay.
I'm on the fence, but
I barely believe. I did more. Now I push back on it.
Yeah,
because it's.
I do think at one point they're mutually supporting each other, and I can believe that easier than I can believe Andrea and Lexi.
The only thing about Carl and Lindsay is they seem almost, it sounds like they're, sometimes I feel like they're two therapists that are dating, like the way they say everything, it's just all so nice.
Yeah.
And I definitely do think,
it is the beginning, though.
I do agree with what Craig says, that Lindsay controls a lot about how she gets edited on that show, I bet.
I'd be interested to say, why do you think that she gets to do that, and the others, why do you think that
Lindsay gets things by sheer force because she just is such a strong personality?
But I'm saying, why was someone like Kyle, why wouldn't Kyle have the same editing cachet?
He's totally just not as cunning as her.
I see. I so think. you're saying that the crew and the editing subs let them be manipulated by Lindsay.
I believe Craig's comment when he said that about her, that she has input and control of her edit. I believe that.
Okay.
I would need, now that's not on based on evidence.
No,
this is a Craig Conover.
I know. I'm just trying to think of.
But there's no evidence, but my gut goes, huh.
But
yeah, I can see that working.
They ask her to be on the show.
Yeah.
Like, in other words, I'm saying
because
they have the power.
They do, but also, we've said it, who is the best cast member on that show? Who's the best cast member on Summer House? Who's the most fun to watch? Who's the most engaging?
Oh, I see.
Who had...
I think it's Lindsay. Yeah.
By far.
I think where I would... It's not that I disagree with you. I think it's a little bit of sour grapes saying any of these people could have control over.
Oh, totally Craig sour grapes.
If Craig is saying that, he's implying that Lindsay has some stake that the others don't have.
Maybe
and
she
it just,
does. We don't, I mean, I don't see how, but maybe
that's
she does.
What I was going to say. How?
Yeah, I'm saying there's no fact, but there's just when he's, but you know how sometimes when someone says something, you go, that makes sense. Like my gut tells me that makes sense.
I would agree, but what I'm saying is, none of the others, they're all paid. Probably the older ones are paid more.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
But the Carl, Lindsay, and Kyle all would have just as much access to the edit. So I call a little bit of bullshit on that, and it feels like sour grapes to me. Mm-hmm. So I don't know. Yeah. But saying Lindsay's the mastermind behind her edit.
She's not I don't think she's a mastermind of the show. But yeah, this whole... reunion left me with conspiracy theories, honestly, about this show.
What one thing I could say is the editing could say, we like it when Lindsay gets favorable stuff.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think that's her doing it, though.
Not according to Craig, but
right.
I agree with you. I don't see how she could do it either.
I just, and maybe she's sending muffin baskets to the editing.
Maybe.
I just...
You know how you talk about your twitchy intuition? Like, I just have an intuition. But after this whole reunion, I have such tinfoil hat about this whole thing because I just feel like another, maybe it's Winter House, but I feel like another show has happened that we haven't seen.
Speak more about that.
Just the coldness from Lindsay and Carl, and then the extreme anger from Ciara.
Coldness to who?
To kind of like, they just feel like, to me, I felt like they felt very just on topic and very on message. And we'll see what they're like in season and part two. And so that contrasted with the just hatred of Paige and Ciara. And then even this was, I was surprised that Kyle actually,
he
did in a very nice way. But even Kyle, really, if you look back, who did Kyle agree with more in the house? It was Paige and Ciara, not Lindsay.
Amanda's right there, though.
But normally Kyle doesn't do that as much.
Yeah, you haven't been watching.
At least for the seasons that I've seen.
When Amanda is around, Kyle sides with the clique Amanda's with.
So,
When he's by himself with Lindsay, he'll say, "You're fine. I love you. You're my best friend forever." Yeah. But when Amanda is there, he will think about it as defending Amanda. Especially if Amanda will say things. Yep.
So, I don't know.
He folds whatever she wants to do.
Winter House is going to be a ride, I think. I think it's going to be a very dramatic season.
I want to know... What did you think of Paige's body language the whole time?
No, that's what I'm saying. She came in like, I thought, and I know you don't.
Andy called it out.
I thought Andy did a great job on this one.
I will say, the one thing I did not like was when he talked about visiting their house and calling it disgusting. And I'm thinking, I wonder what your house looks like after a drug-fueled orgy.
Probably.
But I will agree with you. He did it in his weird, judgy, like, eye roll, like,
the thing is,
gross mouth.
I wish you would say it without, but he's not an interviewer. He's a host.
Well, don't you think you're not a journalist? Do that?
Yeah, he's not a journalist. Like, right. He totally is like, your body language and everything. It was great for him to call out, though, but yeah, she was, that's where I'm like, we are missing something, because she was just so wide-eyed, just, that was Christy at the Clinique counter when she got blivid.
Let me tell you
blividness.
Let me tell you what I think happened. It was all in the seating. I think Paige is not comfortable unless she's in a bunch of the girls who enable her.
Well, it didn't make sense for them. I mean, maybe it didn't make sense that she wasn't by Ciara, since they were a twosome this whole, you know, because Paige always sat by Hannah before.
You said it didn't make sense? It
didn't make sense that they didn't seat them together.
Right.
Why not put Luke or even Maya over there, or someone who's a little bit more impartial?
I don't know.
They always had Hannah and Paige together.
Right.
Always. So why would you not do
she
that?
Here's why she acted that way. I think she was thrown, but she was thrown off her game.
Yeah.
Because there wasn't... The thing about what Paige can count on in this house is that Ciara and Maya will always back her up.
Yeah.
Those are her lieutenants. Yeah. They will never disagree with her. Mm-hmm. They are a triplet. They are a trio unit. Mm-hmm. And when she doesn't have that, she's a little at sea. She doesn't necessarily, she even says, none of these people like me over here. And it sounded like she was 9 years old.
No, yeah. I mean, but just rage.
And that's when, and she's like, see, these people don't like me. These people don't like me. She even pointed at Kyle when she was saying that. And he kind of went, oh.
Yeah.
And Danielle as well.
She's right. I don't think any of them do. None of them like her. And she's never liked them.
Yeah.
That's why it was a look. Well, this episode, this reunion, starting to literally take back the curtain.
And what's interesting is Andy is trying to have fun a little bit with who cleans up and blah, blah, blah. We all know Ciara and Paige do nothing when it comes to that.
And that's where, yeah, we all know that. But yet how they seemed, because who was it that commented on that?
But they couldn't even make jokes about it.
They were... Like, they couldn't make, Paige and Ciara couldn't make jokes about it. And then was it Carl?
Carl said something like.
But even Carl didn't joke about it. Like, that's where I'm like, that's why Carl and Lindsay still made me bristle too, because they just seem so stoic and like, but angry as well, honestly.
I didn't think Lindsay was angry. I think she was letting everyone else talk.
I think she let Carl be her talking boy. I think she was really keeping quiet.
So you think
everybody seemed so angry.
I agree, but you think that was, she told him before, you're going to do that?
Yes, she did.
Interesting.
She works in PR. I love Lindsay, but you're thinking
that she's going to say, Carl, you're going to say everything for me tonight.
I think she probably said, I want you to, you're going to talk about this and that. Yes, for sure. Because he overly
interesting. No, I agree that her. I think that's an instinct he has.
Yeah, for sure.
But I don't think she told him to do that. I think she knew to sit back and to do what's going to happen.
Possibly, yeah.
But I don't think she would go that far with him.
Oh, I do.
Yeah, I don't.
This woman made a list of her life. She's totally type A.
I'm not saying.
I mean, Lindsay is controlling. She said that. That's a level of using someone you're with. Controlling in all of her relationships.
True, but that's. It's different to say, you're going to be my attack dog tonight, regardless if these people are your friends or not.
Yeah.
That's different.
I think it's different, but I think she did.
All right. We'll move on. So moving on, this is, what's your next teabag?
Let's talk about kind of teabag. It's kind of the first topic they talk about. Hot Hub Summer.
Okay.
And the slut shaming and
all
that.
Let me say this. It's no one's right to talk about anyone's miscarriage at all.
I agree.
Keep it out of your fucking mouth or what it means. It's not, and especially when Paige says Luke didn't have a miscarriage, what her miscarriage means to her or what happened to it has no bearing on, if she says it has no bearing on it, fine, you leave it alone. And Amanda wouldn't step to that. And like even...
Maybe because I'm a guy, that's my instinct, and maybe other women feel that. And it would be different if it was like, let's say Paige had, or Amanda had a miscarriage, and Paige went up to Amanda and said,
"Yeah,
I'm worried." It would even be different if Danielle
had
gone up to Lindsay.
This is fake concern.
It feels like fake concern. And
this whole scene creeped me the fuck out.
It just seemed like it was totally fake. It doesn't really matter in what we think, but Lindsay seemed kind of like, was it shocking to me the way Lindsay kind of just, at least on camera, we don't know in personal life, but seemed to just kind of get over that? Yes.
Right.
But what am I going to say? That's her process.
Exactly. And that's her variation. If you're going to ask her about it, you need to have some type of emotional connection to her, which you don't have.
Y'all don't.
And that's where it felt condescending in the worst way for me. And
I think Faye would have the similar reaction. Well, Lindsay would never do that. But it would feel like, it almost did seem like they wanted to show, like, because Lindsay doesn't love to show vulnerability, and they talk about that later, especially with women. And which I think is true, but it's almost like they wanted to show like a crack in the glass.
Yeah.
It felt like that was the reason for doing it, not true concern.
But she can do that with someone like Carl.
Yeah.
You did.
Yeah.
She said Luke can do whatever he wants on a blah, blah, blah. And Paige had the nerve to say Luke didn't have a miscarriage.
I think it's...
Keep that word out of your mouth.
It's just not...
Especially when it relates to Lindsay.
Let that go. Just like, yeah, it's... If you had said other things in your testimonial, but you did call it a brothel. Like, you used a very... to use the Lindsay word, very activated word that suggests shame for women that just wraps in self and sex shame.
And basically what they were saying is Lindsay should take her miscarriage and go into some type of sexual hiding or they didn't think that was the appropriate way to respond to a miscarriage. That's what they were telling Lindsay.
It's that thing that women say a lot, mention, talk about other women's bodies. Fact. But women shouldn't talk about other women's. Like, we just shouldn't talk about women's bodies and what happens with that. It's just, like you said, it's take it out of your mouth.
Well, and it just, it's a reason to find another way to weaponize your dislike of her. Yeah, and that's the worst part of it. But, oh God. Anyway, there. Did you notice that they came? Let's talk about, I think this is when they're talking about it. That happens later on. But Luke suggests the same thing, Paige, about Craig and Andrea.
Mm-hmm.
About the kind of the same issues of playing both sides that mm-hmm. Lindsay was doing with Austen and, that Ciara was doing with Austen mm-hmm. and Carl. And it's almost like Paige won't even accept that that is a reason for anything.
Her response was that she had admit that her response to that was Luke didn't have a miscarriage.
Yes.
Yeah.
I just found it so awful.
She just doesn't need to talk about that. That's her business.
My next, what did you give one or?
No, go ahead, because I brought that up.
I think this goes kind of right when we're talking about Carl is 15 months sober. And they're talking about what's the difference, and Kyle says that's the definition of a 180. He's better, that he can go to other places, go to other towns when I'm not there. And Paige is rolling her eyes during this whole segment. Something happened between her and Carl, too.
No, like something, because Carl said earlier, like he called her out and said, well, Paige, you don't bring your relationships to the show.
Yeah, that's within this section. Yeah. And which is true. She had the relationship.
Maybe
Perry,
now she feels like she has something to protect because now it's a public. Yeah.
Because her other relationships, when she was dating someone, she never brought them. Yeah. Or she would say they couldn't come.
Mm-hmm.
And because it's interesting because we haven't seen this, I would call it salty Carl. We have not seen salty Carl since like the first part of season 4.
Mm-hmm.
And he was kind of good during a lot of season 4, but he's taken it on now. But what she said was right after that, he said, you never bring your boy. Then she said, well, what did you do this summer, Carl? Again, horrific. We know he didn't do a lot this summer because he was sober.
Yeah, it seemed like you're angry and you're saying, I didn't think that was horrific. I just went,
really? Oh, I thought it was.
I didn't think that was horrific. I just thought that has no, that's no standing. Like, what point are you talking about? What do you mean he didn't? His dating life, he was kind of dating that one girl. And like, maybe it was almost as if, that's what I'm saying. They were almost talking about people, like him talking about what she doesn't bring to the show. They were talking about like maybe they've all become too much reality stars.
Yeah.
And Instagram stars and all that. Because for her, it was like she was saying he wasn't entertaining on the show. And
no,
I was like, for who are you to
judge
that?
But that's what I was saying. Because what was underneath that was, since he's sober now, he's not entertaining.
Well, yeah, I can see how you can further, because he called her on that later, and she said, I wasn't coming for your sobriety
right.
at all.
But half of the other people on that panel thought the same thing, and that's when Andy asked the follow-up, what do you mean? And she wouldn't say anything.
Which I don't think she meant that. I don't think she knew what she meant. She was just so angry. It's like that seemed like someone said, they say something, yeah. and you just look at them and say, well, you're a butthead.
And that's when Andy said to Paige, your body language and your behavior right now is wild. And she's like, he's been yelling at me the whole night. And he's like, he hasn't been yelling.
He hasn't been yelling at you. I agree with that. He has not been yelling. But that said, they filmed this for like 5 hours.
Right.
We didn't see the edit.
But Andy would say that.
I feel like if Carl yelled at Paige, they would put that on television.
Yeah.
Because that would be good TV.
Right. But that's when she says the thing about there's a divide in our group, there's a hierarchy. That is true, and that's always been true. Also, you are the beneficiary of this hierarchy. You are the hierarchy that happens when the newer people come in.
Mm-hmm.
and she was trying to act the victim. And I was just like, that's ridiculous. You've been very popular. And that's why it felt like trying to play the victim when she felt threatened. And he was rewriting history a little bit.
Yeah, I could see that. I mean, I think she has been a beneficiary, but I think just because she's been a beneficiary, so it doesn't also mean that she feels hurt or being left out, because it's true. Lindsay is totally exclusive and dismissive of all of them. She has been from day one. You can see it. Everybody can see it. And I think that maybe this is about years of pent up resentment that has become anger that they've never felt included in these. And they benefited, honestly, in their own ways. And it was smart for Paige and Hannah to name themselves the Giggly Squad and then come up with their own podcast and do all that.
I think I would also ask when Lindsay has never wanted to be included in that group, though. She's never, or if she tried to, I don't think Lindsay's the kind of person who would want to be included. Or maybe she is. Maybe we don't see that part of her.
No, she's not. She's not. I mean, you've said, you've talked a lot about Lindsay. You're one that brought this up on the show and said literally almost verbatim exactly what Paige just said. And you've even commented, which is true, is that Lindsay doesn't have good relationships with women.
No.
Because she doesn't want to.
But it's interesting.
She's so threatened or aggressive with women.
But it's interesting why they would want to be accepted by her.
Yeah. I don't see why, especially now, if this was like the first season and you were on and you felt like you weren't accepted by her, or honestly, if Maya was saying this, because Maya's new to the house this season, that makes sense. But it's like, dude, Paige, you've been around for a long time, and Ciara, you've been around for
That's why I think this is
now.
An out-of-date argument.
So it does, yes, it seems out-of-date.
And that's why I was saying it was convenient victimization
Again, something happened for this way that it's being brought up now. I don't know. It was confusing. Y'all, we're going to take a little commercial break. And
we will back me with penis talk about Carl.
Well, I still want to talk about Carl's sobriety and Kyle. I think that was a good one, too. All right, y'all, we're back. So I caught this. I was starting to mention it, and Poodle's like, I didn't mention it. But so
maybe I was looking down.
When they're talking about Carl's sobriety, you know, Andy asked. He full-on asked.
When was this? Do you know when was this?
The first thing, he said, let's talk about Carl's sobriety. And he said, before the page and all that fight, he said, Andy looked at Carl and said, do you feel like now that you're the sober one, do you feel like the tables have turned?
Oh, I do remember this.
And which was clearly indication of Kyle.
I thought he meant that everybody else was just drinking.
No, because they were talking about Loverboy. They were talking about Loverboy and how he's such a good employee at Loverboy now.
He's not getting drunk. That makes sense.
And Andy said right after that, do you feel like the tables have turned? And
I just thought
the camera went and looked at Kyle. The cut to Kyle, and then Carl just said, he basically gave some kind of bullshit answer like, well, I just hope that my actions can have a positive relations on people that are around me.
I thought that was the tables have turned meant that he was such a fuck up and he was the one sleeping methods, and now Kyle is the messier drunker one, yes, but he didn't say anything about alcoholic stuff.
That's the way I took it. It seemed much clearer that basically hinting, is Kyle the problem one now? I mean, I think that,
that's a better way to explain it, because I don't think he would have said.
No, he wouldn't have said that.
But the way you said it was, Andy, so how's it feel for Kyle not to be Kyle to be an alcoholic or something like that? Tables have turned.
Well, because it was just so much talk. Because they didn't say the word alcohol, but they used the language. You're dependable now. We can count on you. Oh, you're a good employee.
That went right over my head.
And then literally, that's when Andy asked, have the tables turned?
Oh, I did not. I thought that was just him being the upright one, less messy one.
Oh, yeah. So, anyway, I just noticed that because I'm always wondering. I'm like, I just think his drinking's going to come up. What's your next team?
But question, do you think that the show would do that? The show has no. It's because it's Bravo. The show has
no,
no
not gonna bring
duty
up drinking and partying because they want people to drink and party.
Yeah, yeah. That's what I'm curious about. Why you think they would bring that up?
They didn't fully bring it up. That's right. What I'm saying. They never will. It was just like a subtextual conversation.
I think it'll all have to come from Kyle.
Oh, for sure.
All of this.
For sure.
So,
like it did from Carl, for sure.
Yeah.
Most people on reality shows on like MTV and Bravo, not most, but a lot of them have, if you look at the litany, that we have sissies that
issues
sober
with
sissies,
addiction.
They say they can't watch these shows.
Yeah.
Because
no,
somebody
I get it.
Have problems, yeah.
So let's talk about
one?
Penis talk. So they have that thing with Ciara saying I want to feel it fucking real bad. And he's like, he has a huge thing. I know it. And Carl said, there was a flash to Carl saying, I don't remember. There was a footage of him in the party by saying
they
7 inches.
Deleted scene.
Oh, okay.
So,
I'm like, I would have remembered that.
Yeah. Carl said it was like 7 inches because Lindsay wouldn't comment on it.
How would they not delete that? How would they delete that? I don't know. You know it. 7 inches is conservative, I have a feeling. I think it's 7.5.
I mean, 7 inches is still
that's a big penis.
That's a nice
big penis.
That, I've been with a 7-incher, and I'm not complaining.
The average is around 4.5 to 5 inches, I believe, for
oh, really?
Male penis. Yeah.
Well, so that's, and y'all, it girthy.
You know, it's
I think
in the
it's
middle.
Thicker than yours.
It's in the middle. Thicker than me.
Thicker than what you think.
Oh.
I don't know anything about your penis, thankfully. I'd like to keep it that way.
I was like, how do you know?
No, I don't.
Jesus. Trust me, you'll never
I
know.
Don't. That's why I don't drive by on Vine in Hollywood because of that billboard.
That billboard.
With your dick on it.
Hey, boys.
Hey, boys. Yeah. I have to go. I have to. Waze just redirects me.
Join pickupfinder.net.
Exactly. Exactly.
What's your next one?
Okay. Let's talk a little bit about, there's not too much more, but where was my notes? I feel like let's start kind of getting this conversation. They're going to about to talk about Ciara's quarter life crisis.
But God, I hate that term.
They're starting to talk a lot about Ciara and Danielle. And I kind of call bullshit on all this because.
How so?
Ciara's upset that Danielle didn't want to get to know her.
Yeah.
Danielle says.
When you call bullshit, what are you calling bullshit on?
And Danielle is saying, I was offended that it seems like you never tried to get to know me. And I went bullshit because neither of you want to know either. Like, it's so clear.
Right.
Y'all don't want to be friends.
No,
so
no,
why
no,
are
no.
we talking about this?
But what did you think about they're talking about, let's put a pin in that because I want to talk about that near the end.
Well, this is teabag, so we can talk about
okay,
that.
Okay, let's
now.
Talk about the glass incident.
Yeah.
So when she, basically Danielle says, I was really upset that you did not reach out and when this
yeah.
aired
yeah.
and say you were sorry. And Ciara gives this explanation. And I was aghast.
Again, Ciara needs and Paige need to hire a good PR
they
person.
They need to hire a Lindsay.
Because as soon as, because you can tell the difference. Because and if they have a PR person now, they need to
they
fire
need to fire them.
Them. Because as soon as that would have, even I don't have a PR person. I just have dead mother Jackie, y'all, who emails me and says, don't say that. But as soon as that would have aired on TV, I would have made a social media post
right.
about it. I would have messaged Danielle about it. I would have got, because it was
that
physical violence towards another person.
Yes.
Like,
yes.
This goes beyond being upset. It's physical violence. Like, you need to make sure. Well, first of all, I genuinely, legitimately would feel very horrible about that.
Right.
But then also, I would want to, but even if I didn't, I would want to make sure you thought I did in the press.
Right. That's the most important thing for a reality show. And you guys, she did apologize to her that night, and we can say that. However, there's a big difference between it happening on reality television and being a physical assault of another person.
Yeah.
And not thinking you needed even PR. And she said, and Danielle said, I wish you would have texted me or something like that. And Ciara says, I would have, but I didn't think we had the relationship, I didn't think you would be receptive, so I didn't reach out. And what that did is it put the onus on Danielle to have a good enough relationship with Ciara, she would reach out.
I call that gaslighting.
Yes, that's. But I was, so, yes.
You know, I think she was gaslighting her to make her feel bad like it was her fault. And it wasn't. I don't care what relationship they had.
That was
if
one of the...
If you have her phone number or even an Instagram DM, you should have just messaged her. And even if she never responded to you or said fuck off,
you could have said it and had it on my phone.
It's not on me.
Yeah.
I said, I'm so sorry.
I could not believe that. No, that was my mouth dropper of the evening.
I was like, girl.
Yeah.
Girl.
Just from a PR standpoint of view.
And Danielle's not on Winter House, right? So
I don't know. Probably not.
I don't think she'll be on the
season. She wasn't there last time.
So I don't think they have collateral damage from that to fuel this fire.
And Danielle, because as time's gone on, I've developed so much hatred towards Ciara because she didn't think anything. She did apologize that night, and it's tricky, you guys, when you apologize that night for anything, because it kind of happened very fast, the glass incident. And it happened in a way that everyone was a little bit shell-shocked by it.
Yeah.
And no one, the weirdest thing is we even brought this up. No one talked about it after. Remember?
From what we saw, yeah.
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 From what we saw, mm-hmm. No one talked about it after.
Yeah.
So it's interesting that it's being brought up now, and it really bothered Danielle.
Danielle and Lindsay had a conversation about it.
Right.
And it is a little bit, Danielle and Lindsay had a conversation about it in that, Danielle and Ciara had a conversation about it. And Ciara did apologize to her on the show.
Yes, that's what I mentioned that. Yeah.
Yeah. So she did apologize. So it's not that she never apologized, y'all. No. But still, it's like, it's one thing when something airs, and then this is the way reality TV works. When it comes out again on TV, that's like when it happened for the first time.
And I want to say, the fact that they berated Lindsay for not apologizing to Ciara, that all three women kept telling her exactly what to say for an apology when Ciara could not apologize to Danielle for throwing a glass.
Yeah. Yeah.
It was just unbelievable.
Think she did on the show. Yeah. Who? I don't think she said I should have. She's only said to Danielle, she said,
who you're saying? I'm confused about
Ciara
who you're saying.
Ciara did say, she said, I'm sorry that I, she said, I apologize. I'm sorry. I should have said, I'm sorry. I should have. She said that she should have texted her.
Yes.
So Ciara, I guess that was the apology that Ciara thought. Cause she did say, cause Danielle went into all that. And then she said, I wish she would have texted. And she said, I'm sorry. I should have said, I'm sorry.
But they weren't happy with Lindsay's very PR version. I'm sorry. I apologize for my part in hurting your feelings.
Yes.
And it wasn't enough for them.
Well, and what they, and that was a part too where they all three, and even Kyle kind of, I was surprised, said, because they don't want her to say, I'm sorry. What they want her to is to admit that she knew what she was doing.
Right.
Which Lindsay will never do.
No.
I 100% believe she did. It's very obvious. And like even Kyle brought up the point, and I forgot about that clip. Like Lindsay keeps saying, I didn't know she was in them. I didn't
right.
know. And I forgot about that video of Ciara literally having a very strong reaction to, like, Lindsay knew.
Yeah.
There's no way Lindsay can. So forth. I think that's what, it's not about the apology. They just want, Lindsay's put her head in the sand in this and isn't acknowledging it. And they want her to acknowledge that she knowingly hurt Ciara.
Right.
And didn't care about that. And because even Danielle mentioned that on the show. She didn't mention it in the tell-all.
Yeah.
But she even asked Lindsay about that on the show.
Did you enjoy it? Yeah,
did
I remember that.
And Lindsay didn't answer that question then.
What did
Again,
you,
I am totally hiring Hub House for my PR, I know. Y'all. What did She's
you,
a master.
What did you think about this? This is one more thing about the glass. I forgot about this. Where they were talking about it, and Ciara said, I don't even remember if I threw a glass or not.
I think that's totally true.
That's a lie.
Oh,
she
no.
said it.
I meant that like...
She said it that night. I'm sorry for throwing that glass.
No. I think you misread that comment. Because Danielle, to me, what I got from that, Danielle was like, did you know what you were doing? I think she didn't... I took a Ciara. She got so angry and kind of like, I think she meant in that moment, did you really, were you?
Oh, that's not what I saw. No, she said, did you throw a glass? She goes, I don't know.
I thought Danielle asked her, did you know, like, were you, I'm blanking on the word. It's in law. When was it like premeditated that you wanted to throw this
No,
glass?
I don't think, no.
That's the way I took it.
Then she would have said no instead of I don't know.
And I thought Ciara's answer of, I didn't even realize I had done it, and that was her, like, kind of, I was blackout angry. That's the way I took it.
Oh, I thought she denied even throwing a glass.
No, because she, it was on TV. I don't think she denied throwing the glass. No, because she apologized and said even on the show, I threw the glass. I don't think she was, like, totally, like, delusional. I took that as she was saying, in that moment, I was just seeing red. I didn't realize what I was doing.
Oh, I was really confused at that.
No, that's what that... I have to see my notes on that. But I don't even think I took notes on that because it was just... Yeah, you were asking her if she was planning on doing that and she got blackout angry.
Planning is that... No, I don't think she was planning on it, but I was really... The other thing that you guys, Paige said, Luke even called this out. Paige said, but you were stoking the fires. And Paige said, and I would do it again.
Yeah.
Paige is not redeemable for me.
Oh, I think Paige is redeemable for me.
I don't know, boy. I think that's just a mean girl thing to say.
I'm just withholding judgment until we see Winterhouse. So, because... Honestly, I think it's all mean girl. Just because you don't say something, neglect and dismissiveness is still just as hurtful to people. And so I think, honestly, probably all of them are behaving badly.
I think
probably the only person that's not behaving that badly in the house that is with this whole, all these women being upset at each other, would be probably, at least from what we've seen, are Maya and Danielle.
Yeah, I'd agree with that.
And I think... we'll see what happens for me. What happens?
One other last thing that I completely forgot, and I think both of us had looked over, is they showed the clip of they went back to Winterhouse and they showed the clip of Austen and Ciara talking.
Yeah,
and we had remembered it as Ciara asking Lindsay if it was okay. She asked Austen if it was okay.
No, I remember talking, because I remember...
I completely forgot about that.
No, they showed... Yeah, I remember it was... because that's where I was saying, and they talked about it on the show. That's what... When all this came back, if you remember you talk on the show, it's like, Austen is the one who's the... And you agree.
But I'm saying...
At fault.
But then how could they be mad at Lindsay for... I'm sorry, that's not clear. Why would Ciara think it was okay with Lindsay?
Okay with Lindsay.
To pursue Austen.
What? Well,
if they never talked,
I wonder. And I felt, I think we did though. I thought they did have a conversation.
No, I don't think they ever did. I think that was it.
I don't have enough time to rewatch Winterhouse, but also too, Lindsay like then started hooking up with Jason though too.
Yeah.
So it's like,
but it's like at the same time you could say Ciara with Carl, I just wondered the double standard here is so strong and why the other three women in the house completely thought of, in other words, why it became even before Lindsay.
I don't remember if or not.
I don't think it happened. No one has perspective of
some
this.
Some sissy who has a better memory will let us know. But because we miss things.
But I was looking back and I was like, did she ever talk to her?
I feel like I remember them having some type of conversation, but maybe I'm just conflating that with Austen and Lindsay having so many conversations.
Right.
Like him telling her no and all that. Winterhouse was such a blur to me because it was the first time seeing it. And
yeah.
It was just a weird show and weird getting used to.
Yeah. There was one other great line that Alex had that talking about Austen as the Honda Civic of male attractiveness.
Y'all, don't forget Alex was there.
I think he's a little more than the Honda Civic. I would say...
No, I think he's Honda Civic.
Geo Tracker. Something sportier.
Maybe. Maybe, yeah.
I don't have anything past that.
Kia Sorento.
This was a lot of tea, though.
Good. You know what? I have to say, honestly, full disclosure, I've been kind of bored with Summer House.
Yeah.
I've even told Jake, I'm like, if this show doesn't get better, I want to drop it and cover something else.
What?
If the show continues to be this juicy, I'm fine with it.
What would getting better be for you? I'm just curious.
Juiciness. Okay. Like, my problem with this show has been people are upset about people not living in this house. That's been so much. And so
like
fine.
Who?
It was just all like, it was Ciara and Austen.
Oh, Lindsay and Austen. I see.
It
yeah.
Was, that's what I'm saying. It was all Lexi and Andre. There was so much plot line.
Yeah.
Luke and Nicole. Like all this shit. I'm like, the whole point is to see the drama between these people yeah. in the house. It was only Kyle and Amanda that were giving us this.
Yep.
So if I agree. It's this show, I mean, it's messy as fuck, but I'm like, this is a show I want to watch.
Yeah. I think the part two of this is going to be even uglier because we're going to get into Kyle and Amanda. But I don't see how Paige and Ciara can ever be friends with or ever be cordial to Lindsay again after this. I just don't see it, especially live in the same house. It's not like the housewives when they live in separate houses.
No. Well, although, you'd be surprised what a new contract and getting paid
true.
New money would get
true.
You to agree
but
on.
But I'm saying I could believe Paige and Lindsay could be cordial to another. I don't think Ciara's a good enough actress to do it because she...
Maybe.
Yeah.
I think they will, though, because at the end of the day... It's harder to not make up with somebody you care about. They don't really care about each other.
That's true.
I think they're going to be fine next season.
I think that's the worst part, and I think that's why it affects Paige and Ciara more, is that Lindsay doesn't give a shit about either of them.
No.
And they get upset because Lindsay doesn't give a shit about both of them.
I think it's all, look, we've talked about anger is it's covering up another emotion.
Yeah.
They're hurt. They're hurt. Their feelings are hurt. They feel excluded or whatever. They feel sad. They feel upset. But it's all they're
I think
using
it's,
anger
I
on top
do
of
think
that.
It's jealousy as well.
That too.
Yeah.
That too as well. I think too that, you know, and possibly maybe Paige is jealous that, although maybe she feels like the press of her and Craig aren't good. I feel like Craig and Paige are getting great press.
No, they're not, actually.
Everything I see, it's always like...
Not anything like Lindsay and Carl have gotten.
Well, no, because she is in PR.
I know.
But I will say, like... But that is... I do feel like... I thought I would like it at first. I don't love this Lindsay and Carl relationship.
Me either.
I feel like I'm watching Stepford Mom and Stepford Dad. Like, they just feel too, like...
I see that. I just think it's fake.
It's just boring.
Yeah.
Boring. I 100% would watch a reality show of Craig and Paige
Me too.
Living out their lives. So, and ultimately, I think Paige... If that is why she's upset, she needs to take a breath and slow her roll. Because let's be honest, Lindsay and Carl aren't going to work out.
They're not going to.
Lindsay's too in her head to make that work out. But I think Paige and Craig could be a long-term relationship.
Yeah, I don't know. I think it might be. I don't think it's as picture perfect for social media as Lindsay and Carl, though.
No.
Yeah.
Because, but again, y'all, you have to remember what I just had a friend the other day talked to me about. He was talking about his marriage and how it's so terrible and stuff.
But
so
they
shitty.
Look perfect on social
and
media.
And then on Mother's Day, I see the most glowing posts yep. on social. So what happens on social media isn't real life.
I agree with you.
I'm just saying. So I'm telling people that are like, so happy. You don't know. Poodle and I haven't been talking for 3 years.
I'm just a disembodied head.
Yes.
Yeah.
He has no legs, everyone.
Yeah.
That's a robot at those live shows. Speaking of, come see us. And
did we not talk about these before?
We didn't talk about, but come see us Summer of
Fun.
Wow,
you're just on a loop.
We didn't talk about a lot of announcements, actually. We did talk about the live shows. Go to reality.
Oh, wait, we already did a show today.
Yeah, you're thinking of the other show. Also, y'all, this is because this is on a free.
Oh, weekend. You're right. We didn't. That was the Below Deck.
Yeah, it's Below. So come see us this summer. Columbus, Minneapolis. We'll be in Luke's neck of the woods. Columbus, Minneapolis.
Ooh, Luke.
I know.
Taking tap my maple syrup.
Phoenix.
Ooh.
Detroit.
Salt Lake City.
Salt Lake City.
San Diego.
San Francisco.
Other sands.
Dallas and Austin. We're going to be coming to all those cities. Also, we want to remind you, if you are in the Sissy Squad, that our charity this month is, where is it? I had it. I'm going to say it wrong unless you remember it.
It's something.
I don't want to say it wrong. I don't want to say it wrong. It's a National Network of Abortion Funds.
So,
because we believe in women's autonomy to the bodies.
Women's bodily autonomy. And as also, you know, this is helping women who live in states which may make rules that restrict heavily or ban abortion to go out of state to get that procedure.
Exactly. So if you're in the Facebook group, that's a pinned post. You can donate at the top. Or if you're not in the Facebook group and you're like, I don't fucking like Facebook, that's fine too. We just want to make you aware of the National Network of Abortion Funds. Google them and you can give to them directly. All right, everybody. Oh, man, I just saw that. I looked on an old note of that 90 Day Fiancé episode that's called Pasta La Vista. Now I want pasta.
Lord.
And I want pasta and a Moscow Mule with muddled berries.
Oh,
from talking
God.
About Below Deck. Y'all, it was a good episode of Below Deck.
You take grape juice,
Below Deck,
vodka,
I would, Below
and
Deck
Red
and
Bull.
Summer House finally brought it both this week.
Both episodes.
They were getting low, and this was fun to talk about and to watch. So y'all tune in next week. We're going to be talking about part two of the messiness that is Summer House. But until then, how do we end this show?
You don't know.
Oh, I remember now.
Now, till then, if you're around the Summer House with a black light like Andy Cohen was and going, this is disgusting. Why does it smell bad in here?
And then you see on the wall something written in semen.
and also outlined in red lipstick.
Bright red lipstick. And red lipstick.
And it just says, Who's Tracy?
And the slow part of the end. In September, they'll all go back to their Google Hangout, their Zoom, and their Slack. And even though summer came to an end, they'll continue to be best of friends
on Insta.
Summer's nuts. Because of these sluts.
Oh.
But,
what are you gonna do?
That summer.